Welcome to
Jai is our light and salvation. Whom shall I fear?
This time we're going to learn about
in a dim light, dreadlocks in moonlight, ballad at sunrise.
Okay, so in part one we looked at some basic elements of isometric sketching, the rules about keeping your horizontal lines at 30 degrees to the horizontal, vertical lines vertical, parallel lines parallel, and all of that. Now in part two we introduce a little bit more complexity, enabling you to sketch like full objects with different details and features, and we'll also have a little look at use of colour and things like that. I picked one of the objects from the assignment to draw, which is a cute little Art Deco radio, and I'm just going to quickly set myself up for doing it. So you can see I've got a set square here just to help me get set myself some basic framework to work in. So now you might notice there's no little animals or critters around today. Well, to be honest, I gave them the day off because I find this bit stressful enough as it is, because as you're about to find out, I'm actually not very good at it. I'm trying to quickly construct myself a little working space that I can draw the radio in. You can see the basic crate is taking shape here. I can't be bothered to measure the angle of that. I'm just checking that that's parallel to there. It's good enough. Same again with this line. It's got to be there somewhere. And how long is it going to be? Well, somewhere around about there, I reckon. Okay. Right. Okay, now I always find it handy just to sort of loosely pencil in where the reverse side of the crate would be, because it helps me to imagine it all in three dimensions. Okay, now we've got a few other features that we could just start to sketch in already. So on the top there is a handle which must be on the center line, and it is going to have a little crate that probably looks something like this. Notice that I'm doing all of these lines really, really gently at the moment, because they are only construction lines and they might not actually be there in the final drawing. Okay, so there's a little crate for the handle, we'll leave that for now. There's also down on the bottom here, there's a couple of probably a tuning knob and a volume knob or something. So they're in this little space here and there. Although, I mean, obviously they're cylinders, but we're going to stick to the crating technique and then going to create a couple of little crates for them in. Okay, in the background you can hear Lee Scratch Perry murdering little fluffy clouds by the orb. Okay, I think those will probably do for that. Something slightly weird about that one, but it'll do for now. It probably dips too much at the front. Okay, what else have we got? Of course, one thing is the curviness at this end. Now, I suspect that that's based on a full circle. So let's divide my space into two at the front into two squares, and then if I just join the corners, that tells me that the center of my circle is going to be there, top is going to be there, bottom is going to be there, and It's gonna rock, so it's obviously got to hit there, and it would be an ellipse. So let's just pencil, if it was a full circle, let's just sketch the ellipse in. God, here we go. Just about held that together. And now I'm almost in a position to start sketching in the whole of the rest of the radio, but I do need to just be aware that these here, here, here and here are not sharp corners, so I'm not going to draw heavy lines right up to the corner. Also, of course, I've got a line here. The radio doesn't actually extend to there, does it? Because beyond about there, it'll have disappeared from my line of sight as it comes around the corner at the top. Okay, so I can draw that line in more heavily now. I can probably draw this line in more heavily. It's got to come and meet that. There we go. Now, another thing to notice is that as much as I possibly can, I'm trying to avoid doing this thing where you do multiple pencil strokes, because in the end, it just ends up looking like some kind of discarded cat's toy. Again, I'm not really going to pencil that edge in yet, because I know that it's quite rounded in the design, and say this corner is probably going to fall away this way. Again, it's going to curve around there, isn't it, quite tightly. I'm going a bit stray with my line there, aren't I? Okay, hate it when I do that. So let's just leave that like that for now. Eventually the corner is going to be roughly sort of that shape, and that's going to fall away like that, isn't it? And this line here is obviously going to be visible. Going on there that I'm going to deal with right now. Okay, where have we got to? Let's put the tuning knobs in. So remember, isometric view of a circle is an ellipse. That's roughly nothing like an ellipse. An isometric view of a circle is an ellipse, and then those. Something like that. Let's get rid of some of my crates while I'm at it. It doesn't matter when you're rubbing things out, obviously it doesn't matter if you accidentally rub out lines that you've been over that you want to keep, because you can just go over them again. There is actually a sort of marked, kind of some kind of marked feature or moulding about there actually, which means it must have a step there. Handle, it's gonna, comes up, goes along, goes down, comes up, goes along, disappears from view. There we go, and then let's get the feature of the face in. So here's my vertical line that defines the center of the circle, and it's slightly away from, obviously it's still going to be an ellipse. And it's going to be roughly like that. And then there's the whole sort of rim feature of the clock face, which again is going to be in the ellipse. And then I bet there's actually a face there which we might see the edge of, like a glass across the front. Now the center of the hands, of course, is going to be, this was on the front of the radio, and the center of the hands is actually behind it, of course, isn't it? So I can draw them centered around this line. It should be, I'm going to draw them in pretty vaguely actually, because they're going to look something like that. And because there's actually a bit of a wall in here, where would that disappear? There. Enthusiastic about the length of my clock hands there. Right, okay, I can do a bit of rubbing out. You don't need to watch all of that. Okay, so that's not looking too bad. And now I think we can start thinking about adding some colour. Now I'm not going to stick to the colours on the photograph. I'm just going to make up my own colours based on the ones that I've got to hand. And I'm going to use pencils because I think it generally gets a better result than using pens. Obviously you can watch hours of this sort of stuff on YouTube with graphic designers doing amazing things but with amazing pens. So the outcome of this will depend largely on the quality of tools in your household. So when we're starting to think about shape, colouring things in, we've got to think about several different things. One is we've got to think about the texture of the surface. You know, if it's wood, obviously it's got a grain. If it's a dull surface, then it's not going to reflect any light. If it's a hard surface like plastic or glass, then it is. And in fact, if you look at most objects, or many objects, particularly those made out of hard, bright, shiny, plasticky things, you'll notice that there's parts of them that almost, you're reflecting so much light out at you, they almost look white. And that's what I'm going to try and capture in this drawing. So for this, I'm going to presume that the light is falling on the object from about this direction. So we'd expect to get some sort of reflection off this surface, maybe off an edge here or something. We might get some reflection at the tops of these, and probably all the way along this round the edge of the radio. We're probably, it's going to mostly look white. So I'm going to try and capture that with my green pencil. I don't know where I'm even going to start doing that. I'm going to start up here, I think. Now, you'll notice that I don't just do random colouring in strokes, because pencil does layer up quite easily, and if you just scribble all over it like that, the whole thing starts looking like a mess rather than a product. But again, you don't need to watch all of this. So, that's better. Note, I've tried to make it a bit darker back here, where there might be a bit of shadow. Also, sort of down here, it's going to be much darker. A bit more dark around here, a bit of shadow. And I've tried to keep all of this white to show the reflected light. Let's bang some handle shading in. Again, might have some light glinting off that far end and off this face a bit. Maybe in a couple of wavy lines. You might have seen cartoonists do this to represent glass or other shiny surfaces. A couple of wavy lines of light. It's difficult to do in small areas. Again, a couple of bands of reflected light off here. I think the battery's about to die on the tablet. It keeps bleating at me. We'll see if I can get away with this. A bit harsh there. Probably a bit of reflected light off there as well. And there, a couple slice of it like that maybe. Yeah, quite like that. This one's probably going to have slightly curvy, this I think, so I'm going to have some light on just this end of it. There we go. ended up with less light on that than I wanted, but I wanted a bit more of a white patch along here. Do a faint wash over for a bit of slightly blue tinted glass over the front. Again, a bit of whiteness at this end of it. Kind of want to colour this as well though. This is also red. And probably quite dark because it's hidden from view, hidden from the light. So I'm just gonna actually shade that over with some normal pencil as well, just to accentuate the darkness of that. Alright, well, I'm pretty pleased with that. So I'm going to show you a couple of further finishing touches in a minute. Just going to take a rest. So another nice trick is to give your drawing a bit of background, and this is quite effectively done with a decent broad felt tip pen, and I'm just going to show you the start of it and then we'll fast forward again because it's a bit dull watching the whole thing. But basically, I don't want to go over the edge of my drawing, and at the same time I don't want to colour all round it like this. So I'm going to go carefully round, trying to keep to the 30 degree angle of the isometric view. Okay, so you can obviously, I can continue that all the way around here, and then it would go all the way down this edge as well. I'll fill it in and you can see the finished result. There you go, it helps to create a bit of a scene that your product can sit in. Again, take care with felt tips. You can see that it's difficult to avoid too much texture, and also of course depending on the quality of your paper and your felt tips, you got to watch out for the paper getting really soggy and starting to go all wobbly. And last thing, here's a little technique, it's called thick and thin line or something like that. It's very straightforward. You just got to imagine there's a spider crawling around your product, and every time it goes around an edge that means it goes out of view, that edge becomes a thick line. So for example, all of the outside along here is a thick line. Going wrong already. Right, I'll show you. Okay, that could carry on all the way around. If I take a little detail like this, of course this is all thick line, wavy thick line albeit, and so is that, but then this line and this line are all thin lines. Okay, back when I've done. Hey, so that's it, job done. Can't wait to see some of yours. Oh, hang on, wait a minute, what's this? I'm being handed something. The team have just said to me they wanted to take advantage of the day off, but for some reason they can't go out anywhere, so they've had their own go. This was the mousse. Not bad. Nice bit of shading here to show the grain structure of the wood. Bit of reflection going on the wheels. Fantastic effort. This was KV, who despite his appearance actually likes his toiletry products and chose to draw a bottle of aftershave or perfume. There you go, again, nice bit of texture here. Quite interesting how he's managed to show that it's got some liquid in it, and notice the clever isometric lettering as well. And then last but not least, this was T-Rex, believe it or not, who was bold and had a go with some felt tips. Bye for now.